Bougainvillea. The lovely birds and a note on. The cool sea. This is an adaptation for the BBC, and they are generally wonderful. 9 out of 10, I guess. Even when the subject is odd. I'm thinking Death on Taxes, an adaptation based on the diaries of Andy Warhol. And they were marvelous. they had interesting figures, characters, from Truman Capote to Mick Jagger and his wife Bianca, Basquiat and Trump have portraits in that excellent, if strange, play. This one has an awful subject, war. And the cruelty at war, wherein so many people die. And I was thinking a few days ago about what to read, and it's evident that a balance is needed. Talal Ben-Shahar, in his positive psychology lectures at Harvard, mentions this. If we have negative thoughts in mind, negativity would result in a negative life, so to say. Buddha says something like, we have the life we think about. Words create worlds. There is nothing either good or bad, but thinking makes it so. Shakespeare. And so many other. That's all. Termina. For some reason, he wants to poke holes in my shirts. Anyway, but if the books we read are positive, there will be positive thoughts, and we feel better. If we read only about war, people dead, so many dead. We get depressed. It's true, there are alternatives to that. I mean, we read this and we understand suffering, and we must realize then how wonderful our life is, and how lucky we are. And it's not a question of you have to, when so many bad things happen and have happened in the world, you can't be happy. That's how some people. You can't be selfish. No, it's exactly the opposite. When you are happy, those around you get happier in various degrees. And the opposite is true. If you start moaning and complaining about the world and the many misfortunes and disasters that are happening in the world. That's also true. And we can't be insensitive to that. But we must do termina empathy and compassion. But we must try and experience post-traumatic growth. That is, we learn about these negative events in the life of others and ours, but we need to grow and become stronger. So, as I was saying, it's a familiar, in many ways, a familiar story of conflict, convoys of ships, many of which have been sunk by the U-boats, and there are scenes of love, of redemption, the post-traumatic growth, if we will, and sometimes rare, we have rare occasions when it is even funny. I was thinking when they surrender, there's no spoiler alert needed, I'm sure of that. You know how the war ended, okay? So when the Germans surrendered, they talk about two submarine U-boats coming to, at the end of the war, to present their surrender. And at least one of them is arrogant and proud. He comes, the narrator is saying, like he's master of his domain. And so the captain decides to order, you should shoot the hair off that bastard. That is not kill him, but just show him. In fact, he even says words to this effect, if not the exact quote. Show him who is master. We won the war. But there are some terrible, overwhelming experiences. People get blown off the water. In one case, it's a mistake. They're killed by friendly fire. There's this feeling that wrong impression that there's a submarine in there, and they just drop loads of explosive while people from another ship were floating around, and then they're just blown to pieces without the justification that it was meant to kill this boat, which will kill so many more. And another instance with dead bodies who've been floating for a long time, and the seagulls have taken the eyes out, and it's so terrible. Come to think of that, with the decision of bombing that supposed submarine, it reminded me of an image from a recent film wherein they were trying to break the Enigma code. They did. One of those in the team had a brother on a convoy which was going to be attacked, and Sam. He's desperate because he says, well, now we can tell them. And the others say, rightfully, if it sounds heinously, no, we can't, because the Germans would know. If we do this now, they would know, we'd change that, and then so many more would die. So we have to let those there die just to try and save so many others. That's war.